Hey Bethel family, glad to see you all today. You should know who I am by now, but if not, I'm Sister Shakoya. Let's get into today's announcements. Today, we would like to welcome our sister congregation, Temple Israel, who are joining us at our 11 a.m. worship service to celebrate the life and legacy of Reverend Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. It's prayer time at Bethel. Last Sunday, we launched our legacy campaign, as well as our spiritual prayer journey for 40 days. As a church, we are committing ourselves to stop, pause, and pray daily at noon for 1 minute. If you would like to be a part of that, please see Reverend Sabrina in the hall directly after service to sign up and pick up your copy of the Spiritual Journey devotional containing daily spiritual meditation. On January 27th, Bethel will kick off our prayer and evangelism service. Come out and join us as we pray for our church body, the nation, and our evangelism efforts. The next meeting of the Bethel Women's Ministry Book Club will be January 21st, when we will be discussing the book Hidden Figures by Margot Lee Shetterly. The Bethel Worship and Arts Department has new emails for your convenience. Please feel free to use the contacts listed in the bulletin and on our Bethel AME website for all ministry inquiries.
1 out of 4 human beings with their hands on bars, shackled, in the world are locked up here in the land of the free.
Khalif Browder was walking home from a party when he was stopped by police.
Then they said, we're gonna take you to the precinct and most likely we're gonna let you go home. And then I never went home.
The 13th Amendment to the Constitution makes it unconstitutional for someone to be held as a slave. There are exceptions, including criminals.
The loophole was immediately exploited. What you got after that was a rapid transition to a mythology of black criminality.
Some people got the real problem.
Animals, beasts that needed to be controlled.
You better believe it.
I'm only human.
It became virtually impossible for a politician to run and appear soft on crime.
The kinds of kids that are called super predators.
Millions of dollars will be allocated for prison and jail facilities.
3 strikes and you are out.
It was an enormous burden on the black community, but it also violated a sense of core fairness.
States were required to keep these prisons filled, even if nobody was committing a crime.
It's so difficult to talk about mass incarceration because it has become heavily monetized.
The focus is on taking people from prison, putting them in community corrections, parole, and probation.
How much progress is it really if now there's a private company making money off the GPS monitor?
We now have more African Americans under criminal supervision than all the slaves back in the 1850s. I'm only human.
We are the products of the history that our ancestors chose. Products of that set of choices that we have to understand in order to escape from it. We should go looking somewhere high.
I'm only human. For more information about the video you just watched, please join Pastor Ray on Thursday, February 2nd at 7 p.m. for the next GBIO meeting, where we will be taking a deeper look at this issue. For more information on today's and other announcements, please visit BethelAME.org and our other social media outlets.